wish you had Photoshop but don't have the budget, no problem. We are going to be looking at two absolutely free alternatives to Photoshop. We're going to put them to the test and see if they can compete with the real deal. Are you ready? Let's do it. Hey guys, Ryan here at Signature Edits, and as mentioned, we are looking at two free Photoshop alternatives for you. Both of these are online image editing pieces of software, so it's really amazing. You can go to freephototool.com or to photopea.com, and you have this beautiful Photoshop-looking window in front of you. We're going to put it to the test and see how it compares to actual Photoshop, starting with our PSD files. So the beauty of both of these is you can actually run Photoshop files and edit them within these programs. So I just dragged it in there, and we'll see, 1, 2, 3. And you can see it's loaded up the photos, loaded up the fonts, as well as all of the files. We've got all of our layers here on the side. Our project is exactly as I saved it in Photoshop, which is pretty cool. The amazing thing about it loading the fonts automatically is, unlike Photoshop, where you have to go and manually add your fonts to Fontbook before you get started, with this particular piece of software, both in Photopea and in Free Photo Tool, it will automatically find your fonts 80% of the time. Sometimes you'll have to add your own fonts, and you can do that super simply and super easily just by hitting character. And we go up to our font selection here and go to load font. Then we navigate to wherever our font is that we want to install. Okay, so let's actually look at editing inside of here and compare it to Photoshop. So I'm going to launch Photoshop here, drag it over here so we can reference. You'll see they look pretty darn similar. We've got all of the same tools that we're used to seeing inside of Photoshop right in front of us. We can go through, select our layers, edit our text the same way. Just double click here. Text edit test for fun stuff. Great, we can go through and we can change the spacing. So I can go in here and select this, open up my character settings, and spacing is slightly different. So if I were doing this inside of Photoshop and I wanted to change my spacing, I have this little guy right here that shows me my spacing for everything. And this VA, I can go 100 and space things out, where with this, we have to go tracking, and we can take that down to say 25. You'll see we've decreased our spacing. So go minus 50, minus 150, etc. Whatever it is you need. So you see, it's not much of a difference, to be honest. We've got our drop shadows in both of them. Things are showing up well. We can edit our drop shadows just like this. So let's go in here, Ryan, and edit the drop shadow. We've double clicked, go through, change the distance, maybe the spread, make the opacity larger, size larger. Wow, beautiful, good stuff, huh? Now you can see there is a little bit of a lag, but not much at all. It's doing pretty darn good. Remember, it is an online photo application, so what's really amazing about that is you can access this from any computer, anytime, anywhere, as long as you have an internet connection, which is pretty cool. You can use this on your friend's PC or on your iPad even, without having to install Photoshop. So that's a pretty big deal. Now let's move over to do some more complicated edits. I'm going to show you what it's like to go through here. And we're going to grab our crop tool. Yes, I know crop is not super complicated, but bear with me. And we're just going to hit this check mark here, and bam, cropped. Okay? Now, the difference in Photoshop is if I go in here, I'm going to do the same thing, hide my layers, crop tool, select, enter. And we have this stupid lag where, why is Photoshop working so hard to do a simple crop? I don't know. So what's interesting is this project in Free Photo Tool, as well as Photopea, both do a better job with the crop tool. Now, going on to into some actual editing here, we're going to press Command-Z, and you can see that that is actually the exact same. Here, let me hide this so it's a little more sensical. Same keyboard shortcuts as you would have inside of Photoshop, which is really handy, with the exception of a few that apply to whatever web browser you're using. So normally, if I were in here and I wanted to resize this photo, for example, hashtag by Joseph Nagabo for PhotoCred, if you want to check him out, I would just hit Command-T in Photoshop, right? So I grab this, hit Command-T, and I can resize it, make it smaller, bigger, you get the picture. Whereas inside of this, if I hit Command-T, I'm opening a new Chrome tab. So I'd have to go up to Edit, Edit inside of this program, Free Transform, and then I can do the same thing from there. Okay, so let's hop over to Photopea because I haven't made a mess of it quite yet, and we're going to hide these layers, shabam, grab our little image layer, and we'll rasterize it exactly the same as we would in Photoshop. And what's amazing is if you know Photoshop, All of this makes sense. There's no learning curve. It's super quick and easy. And if you happen to use this before you buy Photoshop, you'll learn Photoshop at the same time. So I think that's pretty cool. We're going to press, get rid of that text layer I just made. Go up to our lasso select and just give a test on how some of this works. So let's go up, pretend we're going to lasso out some of this fog, you know, because I'm clearly a Photoshop expert. And hashtag, I very, very, very minimally use Photoshop. I'm not the kind of guy who uses it all the time, but I know the basics, and that's it. So I'm going to hit Shift-Command-I to invert my mask. Okay, so that works the same as Photoshop would. I'm going to hit Command-C and Command-V. And yes, oh, something really strange just happened. I'm not sure. I think it's because I have a different project open somewhere. But let's try that again. Let's go Command-C, Command-V. And there we go, we've copied our fog. And we can then move it around. Now it's selected, I think that's why it's looking so odd. Oh, we've really made a beautiful, beautiful, this is creative to the utmost, hey? Now, I don't know exactly what happened, probably because I inverted my mask or did something wrong along the way. Let's try this once more. Let's go Command-C and Command-V. Okay, there we go. Now we've got our fog masked out. So you can see it works almost exactly the same. Let's go over to something like the Quick Selection tool and say I wanted to select, oh, I don't know, this nose right here. Go in and I'm clicking and dragging and you can see there's a little bit of a lag. It's not quite as good as Photoshop would be. I'm just clicking. We'll get there eventually, maybe. So there are some limitations. If you want to do in-depth editing, you're going to be a little bit frustrated, but hey, you're still using this on the flipping internet, so that's pretty amazing. I'm going to exit out of that and simply say I'm not going to use that for my purposes, but what I can try is the spot healing brush and see if that works a little bit better. Make my size a little larger, and you know what, first I should show you. We're going to go and grab our quick selection tool and just show you if I wanted to select the nose here. It's really quick, really simple. So Photoshop definitely has the one up on that. If I want to make noses larger in Photoshop, well, that's the only way to do it. You don't want to do it inside of here. So we're going to grab our spot selection tool healing brush, and let's say I want to just do a few test points here and see how it handles it. Oh, I've got to select the right layer first. Go ahead. And it's loading, and you can see that it took a little while, but it does a decent job of intelligently healing those spots. And I'm sure if I was using something a little bit less weird, it would do an even better job. Now let me show you in Photoshop. We're going to grab our healing brush. Where are we? Look for the Band-Aid. There we go. And do the same thing. Grab my right layer. And I'm going to have to rasterize it first. Perfect. And you can see it moves a little faster. Maybe it does a slightly better job, but it's pretty much the same tool, which is pretty incredible for a free program. Now, I'm going to hop over into one last Photoshop project here. We're going to refresh both of these and just show you what I would personally use this guy for and how amazing it is if you're using it as a Photoshop alternative for free online. It's awesome. So let me go here and I have a wedding guide pulled up. It's just a client guide. The purpose of pulling this up is to test how many layers we can actually open inside of here. Will it work with a larger project? So I'm going to grab this guide. It's got several hundred layers, probably 17 different pages here. And we'll let it think for a second. Bam. So you can see, again, it's gone ahead and loaded my fonts, which is really amazing. The one font that I don't believe that it has loaded is going to be up here in my text. Yeah, you can see that. The weddings font, it hadn't loaded. I would just have to find that separately and upload it like I showed you before. Right here, just hit load font. Okay, so let's go back here and let's just edit a few things with the exception of this wedding. I'm going to go through here and say it's Ryan's photography. Move that around. And you can see all the tools are the same as they normally be. If I press Command A, I select my entire page. I can then use my align tools as I would normally in Photoshop. Shabam. And one really nice feature of both of these online apps is you can actually export to PNG with a simple click. It's super quick, super simple, and way better than what Photoshop offers, which is to, again, we're going to open the same guide. It's loaded, and if I want to save as a PNG, I have to go File, Save As, and they have this Export, Quick Export as PNG. But honestly, is it really that quick when you have to go to File, Export, Quick Export? No, that's just dumb. So anyways, we're going to go back here, just show you. I'm going to go through, edit things. Let's say I want to move this line around. Clear my selection. Bam. and it's almost 2019. Go through, so there's page one, I've edited it. Let's grab an image and import that. I don't know what's gonna pop up here. Hopefully it's appropriate for this video. Shabam, and oh, that's a beautiful picture of two people. Perfect. And again, I've imported that. Perfect, I'll put that right here. We're going to resize by going edit, free transform, holding shift, same as I would in Photoshop. Bing, bang, boom. So there is a little bit of a lag. You can see I'm kind of struggling to get it exactly lined up the way I want it, but it works. It's really, really quite amazing how well this works for a completely free Photoshop alternative. In Photoshop, it would be the same process, of course. We go through, we'd edit our text, and we'd have to install the fonts just the same as we would online, so that's not really an advantage or disadvantage. The only big difference you're going to notice is that there is next to no lag. Now, that's because I'm also on a nice computer. So if you're on a slow computer, it might actually wind up being faster to use the web version of Photoshop. I have no idea. You'd have to test that yourself, but that's my hunch. If your computer struggles to run Photoshop, this might be a great alternative. So we're going to go through here, grab our image, and what do we have? We got a beautiful wedding photo in here. Bada bing, bada boom is right there. Drag that in here. Shoot. So you'll notice it's a little bit faster, but more or less the exact same, which is amazing. If you're editing templates in here, if you're doing basic Photoshop work, I would hands down recommend you actually try using one of these online tools, especially if you're only using Photoshop once in a while. Now, when would you want to use the full version of Photoshop and nothing but Photoshop? Obviously, if this is something you do full time, you get paid to do, and you're using Photoshop all the time to edit tons of images or do really in-depth edits, well, then you're going to want to use something that responds quickly. You don't have to deal with bugs or wonder where things are. Although, that being said, most things are exactly in the same place as they would be in Photoshop in both of these programs. You're still going to find that things interface better. So for instance, if you want to edit RAW files, Photoshop comes with Adobe RAW and you can edit your photos there. Or if you're using Lightroom and you want to export photos to Photoshop, that is really quick and simple. Whereas otherwise, to do that with these online programs, you'd have to export to DNG, open them in the online program, export back out. You get the picture. It's not super simple, whereas here it's as simple as going up to photo and then edit in. We hit Photoshop and bam, it is going to be exported over to Photoshop. Super quick, super simple. So that is kind of a couple reasons you'd want to use the normal version of Photoshop. Obviously, it's quicker, it's faster, and it's going to give you better performance. But if you are new to Photoshop, you're just learning, you're considering whether you want to invest in Photoshop, well, this is a great alternative to get you started. Or if you're just somewhere that you don't have access to your normal computer, you don't have Photoshop on the computer you're using, this can get you out of a pinch. And if you're just editing templates or doing basic text work, this can be fantastic. So those are two absolutely awesome free Photoshop alternatives. We've got Photopea and we have freephototool.com. Between the two, I personally find Photopea to be a little bit easier to understand, although they are so similar and you can't go wrong either way. Test them, see what works best for you. So that's it for today's tutorial. If this was helpful for you, please hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe and leave me a comment below. Let me know what you learned, what you think. Would you use this online program or are you sticking with Photoshop? The top comment is going to receive some free Lightroom presets. All right, so I will catch you in the next one.